wrapped up a 35-minute cardio session, which marks my very first cardio session of a four-week prep. What? This kind of just all happened in 1 second. Tony texts me this morning. Hey, I want you to compete September 12th. Mind you, today's August 14th. I'm like, LMAO, I'm on my way to the gym. We'll talk about it then.
How did this all happen? Well, she has made a statement. I want to compete, but I want to compete next year. Since she's ready, she can compete in something. Why wait for a year when you can find out what it is you need to improve now? I text her, and she sent me back an emoji face and said, we'll talk about it in the gym. She had, I think it was just about a little over 4 weeks. And when, you know, as an athlete, as a coach, as a judge, you know, I'm used to looking at these competitors and seeing what's up there. And when I look at her and I look at them, she's very, very close. So I knew that in 4 weeks, we can dial her in. So I know she has it, whether she believes it or not. It's my job to bring it out of her and her to believe in herself that she can do it.
It's something that I've been wanting to do for a while. And now I got a team that's behind me that honestly just believes in me and is ready to push me, keep me accountable. So let's see. Today I woke up at 121 pounds. So let's see what I can do in 4 weeks. Today is August 16th and I am on my way to the gym, obviously. I have my very first posing session. Don't know what to expect. What the heck? I have my bag with my heels, my bikini, and change of clothes because I gotta go do groceries after. But I'm feeling good. Today I woke up at 123.8, which is almost 2 pounds heavier than yesterday. I don't know what it is, but I'm not freaking out. I'm pretty sure that it's because I'm doing more cardio, to be honest. And my cardio of choice has been the Stairmaster, and the Stairmaster always makes me hold on to water. So again, not freaking out about that. I set myself up on a meal plan, and I'm gonna be eating the same foods throughout these next 4 weeks, just to make it easier on myself mentally, easier on Tony when he pulls food. And I just don't want to leave any room for error, you know?
Number 34, Natalie Cardone.
Is hard. My waist, my lower back was just cramping, my legs were shivering. But Shelly, which is the pro that Tony got to coach me for posing, she was a dream. She was honestly so nice. She's like, yeah, when you're on stage, you're gonna be shaking a lot more, so you gotta get used to it. I wanted to introduce you guys to my posing coach, Shelly. She has been helping me perfect this routine for Southern States.
I just love helping girls get ready for shows. I love making it sharp, making them look amazing, feel good on stage.
So you guys are gonna see my routine, and it's all thanks to this one.
Move, bitch, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch, get out the way. Move, bitch, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch, get out the way. Move, bitch, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch, get out the way.
Energy, let's talk about energy. So energy in the morning is kind of sucky. Then I get to the gym and I take my pre-workout and I feel good doing my workouts. And then when I have to do cardio, honestly, I hate cardio. Cardio has been the hardest part up until this point. I'm not gonna be doing this much cardio forever. I really only have 21 days left, so time is passing by, and all I'm focusing on is just doing what I gotta do, showing up daily, putting the work in, getting my workouts in, doing my cardio, and also hitting my nutrition. I'm hungry, I'm tired. My workouts are a lot more exhausting now just because I'm doing more cardio, and cardio is a stressor to your body. And obviously I'm not used to doing this much cardio. But food is not low, not that low. I mean, I feel hungry, but that's because I'm in a bigger calorie deficit because I'm doing cardio. Notice how I'm stopping, like I can't even say full sentences. Today I'm gonna be taking my birthday pictures. So I have a tan on, I feel really good. I hit a low weigh-in this morning. So yeah, I'm on my way to the gym now. I'm gonna do my 40 minutes of cardio. I'm gonna hit a upper body sesh and then get ready to take these fire pictures. It's the day of my birthday shoot. We are here in the studio. Check out these lights though. Woo! She glowy. Super excited. Can't wait to show you guys behind the scenes. I found a microwave in the studio, so we about to heat up our pre-workout, which is just fish and zucchini, because we got goals, you know what I'm saying? If you have a goal and you are committed, you've made the decision, because it's one thing to say you want to do something, but when you decide, that means that you're making a mental commitment with yourself that no matter what comes your way, you're gonna find a way and you're gonna follow through and you're gonna do it.
In the middle of a leg workout, 20 days out, shit's fucking hard, dude. I feel like crying. Makes sense.
Things are getting kind of cool. 13 days out. Looking like a hot mess, this hair, girl. Yesterday was my birthday and I had the most amazing day ever. I could not partake in any drinking or eating of any of the delicious food that my mom made, that my friends brought on the boat, but my heart is just so full because my birthday was amazing. Even on prep, I had such an amazing time. And it was even better because it was not food focused, it wasn't alcohol focused, it was all about enjoying time with the people that I love. So I feel really good today. 13 days out, I'm pulling up to the gym right now to do my last 45 minutes of cardio session before it gets bumped up to 50 next week. So I'm making my breakfast right now. So here I have my food scale and my bowl of oats. I'm just gonna add in 50 grams of an apple. It's 44, 47, 50. Oh wait, no, that's 49. Still 49. 50. The rest the boys get. Casper, Cody, sit. I am 10 days out right now. Cardio got bumped up an extra 5 minutes per week and took out oats from my diet, so I'm gonna miss my oats and my almond butter and my turkey bacon, but it's okay, we only have 10 days left. I am extremely fatigued. This shit is not easy, and I did not expect it to be easy whatsoever, but man, This shit is hard. This really tests your mental strength. This really tests your discipline. This really shows you who's fucking tough. Because you have to be mentally tough in order to be physically exhausted, emotionally drained, mentally fatigued, in order to keep pushing when you want to stop. Every single time that I'm tired, every single time that I want to, you know, go slower on the Stairmaster or not finish my reps, I always think about this. There's always somebody out there working harder than you. And maybe those two extra reps, maybe that intensity in my cardio, maybe it's just going to be that tiny difference that's going to separate me from somebody that beats me. I'm trying to go into this undeniable, not only to the judges, but to myself. I want to step on stage and I want to get a show day and know that I did absolutely everything that I could and I left nothing in the tank. Because that's what's going to fulfill me and that's what's going to make me feel like a winner, regardless of the placing that I get on show day. So every rep, every set is performed with intensity and intention. And I'll be honest, guys, if it wasn't for the vibe in the gym, the constant words of encouragement, I don't know if I'll be able to do it. So I am so grateful for everybody that's around me right now, that's just constantly pushing me, uplifting me, supporting me, asking me if I'm okay, asking me how I'm doing, giving me little pep talks. All of that really helps me just stay focused, stay aligned, stay centered, and at peace with what I'm doing. I don't feel nervous yet. I feel like I'm so just ready to fucking get up there and show my hard work. I'm super hungry. I'm tired. I fucking hate cardio. Yo, I hate cardio. That's the worst part, to be honest. I absolutely hate cardio. But, you know, excuses don't get results. Coach dropped food again and cardio has been increased. This is a point where shit is getting unbearable. Unbearable. Every little thing ticks me off. The light just turned green and you didn't go within 0.5 seconds? Babe! You're driving 5 miles under the speed limit? I find myself doing one of these like at least 5 times per day. Questions from people around me, like, why are you purposely doing this? Why are you causing yourself to feel like shit and be miserable? And like, I don't expect you to get it, but at least understand that this is something that I'm choosing to do because I've set a goal for myself, and bodybuilding and competing is an extreme. It's an extreme. It's not an everyday lifestyle sustainable approach to looking the way that I look. I think that I look fucking great. I look at myself in the mirror every day when I wake up, abs on point, skin tight as hell, no bloat, looking vascular, feeling lean as shit. Go to sleep, still got abs, but I feel like butthole. Like a butthole? That's what I feel like. We are 1 week out and it is, what time is it? Hold on. It is 3:43 right now. I am 2 meals in. I've had a migraine for like the past 2 days. But I just figured that was normal because, you know, dropped food and added cardio and stuff. But Tony just told me to go have a burger. Lord! Yeah, I'm hungry, but honestly, like, we're 1 week out and I can definitely wait. Like, I prefer waiting, to be honest, because I'm scared. Like, what is this burger gonna do to me? I feel like I'm right on track and I'm just nervous because 1 week out and I can hold on, you know, like I'm tough mentally and like it's just 7 more days, but he told me to go have a burger. Coach's orders. I'm like, is this an order or suggestion? He's like, it's an order. So let me weigh myself. 119.8. So I'm gonna go have a fucking burger. I'm gonna go have a burger. Wow! Okay, so I don't think that I've ever gotten dressed this fast, but I'm gonna go get a burger. I'm gonna go get a burger. Yeah! Y'all. We got bacon, we got cheese, no mayo.
This is gonna be glorious. So good.
Cheers. 116.6.
What? This is when you need to allow yourself to be coachable. Despite my fears yesterday of what the heck my burger was gonna do to me, I listened to my coach, because if you have a coach, you don't know what it is that you're doing. You gotta listen to people that know what they're doing. So I was coachable and it worked, because I feel really, really good today.
It's peak week! Woo! We have officially made it to peak week. 3 more cardio sessions, 3 more workouts, and the job will be done. Show day is this Saturday. Check-ins is on Friday. I am super excited. I feel really relieved. I don't feel nervous. I feel very calm. I woke up just very peaceful today, knowing that today was peak week, the start of peak week. Cardio got bumped up an extra 5 minutes. I'm still waiting on Tony to let me know what the game plan is for this week. This morning I woke up at 117.2 pounds. So I feel really good today. So I wanted to just enter peak week with a powerful mood. I'm feeling really good. So let's go to the gym, get our workout and cardio done, and we'll be minus one session for the week. It's grind time, baby. We're almost there. We're almost freaking there. We're almost there.
This has been the hardest year for me mentally. I have been at the lowest of the low, and through my hardships, through my pain, through my suffering, through my mental struggles, it was really hard seeing the light at the end of the tunnel. Working out has allowed me to find my strength, not only physically, but mentally as well. And putting myself through a prep like this, seeing myself progress, seeing myself grow in ways that I've never thought was possible, is something that I'll be proud of forever, regardless of my placing. I continue to surprise myself with my mental strength and tenacity to always continue pushing regardless of how I feel. I show the fuck up not only for myself, but for all of you who look up to me for motivation, inspiration, encouragement. So I will continue pushing, and I will never allow myself to be comfortable, because no growth happens in a comfort zone.
Something that I have not stopped taking during this prep has been my OptiGreens. When you're prepping, or when you're in a calorie deficit, when you don't have enough food in your system, your digestion does get impaired, just because you are eating fewer calories, fewer carbs, you don't have enough fiber to add bulk to your stool and like move things around. So OptiGreens has been essential, and it's been helping me with having regular BMs every single day, which is really good because it doesn't affect my weight and I can actually see how I'm looking every day. 3 days out, people! 3 days out from Southern States. Today is my last workout and last cardio session of this crazy ass 4 week prep. Who told me that I can prep in just 4 weeks? But we didn't. Today I woke up at 115.6 pounds, I believe. 115.6. Y'all, I haven't been this low since I was like born type shit. I'm feeling fucking exhausted, super exhausted. I can't even tell you how exhausted I am. And more so just because I haven't been able to sleep. I don't know if it's the nerves, the excitement, the anxiety, the hunger. The hunger definitely keeps me up. But we're almost there. We're literally almost there. Also, shout out to this freaking zit next to my nose that wanted to show up 3 days before the show. Love that for me.
And this officially marks the end of my cardio for this prep. I just decided to bike ride. We're done, fam. The work has been done.
My body feels wrecked, but I'm on my way to go get a massage now. My whole entire body hurts, and it's really important for you as an athlete to properly recover just as much as you run your body into the ground. So literally not one part of me is not sore, so I'm really looking forward to getting this massage. I am feeling like a million freaking bucks right now. That is exactly what I needed. Oh my gosh. I feel so good. I feel so relaxed. I feel like my body is just like melting. I feel so much more open in my chest and my shoulders, which is definitely gonna help me out with posing. I purchased the package of 3 sessions just so that I can do this more frequently. My body needs it. It is Thursday. We are officially 2 days out from the show. Day 2 of no carbs, and I am a walking zombie. I'm a walking zombie. I'm on my way to go do my nails right now. As you can see, they're like ratchet. I'm gonna go do my nails, then do some last minute errands, get some stuff that I'm missing for show day, and I'll show you guys what I end up packing. So I'm here at Walmart picking up some last minute things for show day. So this is what I got. Cheesecakes, lightly salted, and then I picked up the white cheddar and this apple cinnamon. I have never tried this one, but I'm curious to see how it tastes post show. I think I'm just gonna be having those on show day. And then Nutella, I picked this up for my heels so that they're not slippery. For my girls with, you know, little boobies, this is gonna be clutch to put under the bikini. Then I picked up some loose sweats and asparagus. Our 1 day out, I am packing everything that I needed. It's 11 in the morning. I already had one meal today. I was just starving. I couldn't show you guys. It was just 2 ounces of turkey with 1/4 cup of rice and some asparagus. I'm feeling a little bloated, a little flat. I already made all of my meals. My meals for the next 2 days are packed and ready to go. So I have tilapia, ground turkey, chicken, jasmine rice, asparagus, and I'm taking 1/4 cup to measure out my rice. And then I'm also gonna be sticking my food scale in here. Taking my food scale, obviously, to weigh out my things. And the best part about my food scale is that it just fits perfectly right in there. We have arrived to the hotel room. I have already checked in. I registered. I got my NPC card. I got my number. Everything went so fast. I wanted to vlog everything, but everything just went so fast. As soon as I walked into the hotel, you know, Tony was there, and then I had to register. I had to measure myself, I had to change my bikini. Like, it was a mess. It was really, really fast. But now we're in the hotel room. I just had my 3rd meal. I'm gonna put my feet up and relax until I have to go get a tan, my first coat of tan, and then we're gonna go have a burger. So this is our room for the weekend. I've set up all of my food here. So hello rice cakes, guys. What I'm craving post show is my protein yogurt bowl with my cinnamon cookie batter protein, my granola, my apple, my almond butter. So I have everything set up here. I picked up this limited edition maple cream Oreo to try post show. And then here is my measuring cup. I have my food scale that I'm gonna be weighing out my things. I brought my makeup bag, brushes, 2 scrunchies. Then here's my tripod. I think I'm gonna keep my hair straight, so I brought my iron and all my hair stuff. And then this is my mom's stuff. But the best part is I brought my little sticky notes, because it's been a routine for me to wake up every morning and go to my mirror and just read my 2 favorite phrases. So tomorrow on show day, it's gonna be no different. You got this, and show the fuck up. All right, so here we are with first coat of tan, feeling crispy, feeling good. crazy.
This is so crazy, literally. This is cool. This is so cool. Tony says that I need to fill out because I'm a little flat. So I ordered a burger. It should be here within like the next 15 minutes. So I'm gonna eat that. Obviously, enjoy it. And see how I look in the morning. I see like little ridges like in my stomach that I've never seen before, like striations. Like, what? The hard work, the hard work.
I just got here. My burger. So this is just burger bun, patty, cheese, onions, and pickles. No mayo. I don't even care. Not the best burger I've ever had, but so far, somebody's here.
You're talking, but of course.
Duh.
Enjoy.
Fire.
Enjoy it. You got bacon in that thing, uh-huh. You know, you can put ketchup if you have. If you want.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. There you go.
Thank you. Good. I'm ready.
I'm ready.
Just got done eating my burger. Ugh. Feeling good. Tummy is happy. Wow. Wow, no words. Let it work its magic overnight and let's see how I look like in the morning. Good night. Woo! 7 a.m. This is my first meal. I have 2 ounces of tilapia and 3 quarter cups of rice. And we're about to do makeup. Woo! Hi. I got my makeup girl here. In a little, I won't look so much like a troll, so before. I no longer look like a troll. I am done makeup, done hair, done. Decided to go with straight hair. I got my jewelry on. It's showtime.
Baby,
it's showtime. It's showtime. Check me out.
My makeup, as you guys can tell, it's very bright, very dramatic, very ready for stage. This is my front pose. This is how we're looking. I have one more meal before I go on stage.
So we are heading to backstage. Right now it is 9:50. The boys right now are competing. They're doing their thing. So hopefully I can catch some of the team there doing their stuff. Backstage
that's
right now.
Thank you, ladies.
Room full of beautiful women, competitors who have all worked their freaking butt off to get here. Everybody is so deserving of a place. Oh, wish me luck going on very, very soon. Time for the best coach in the game. Best coach in the game. Coach, coaches, therapist, doctor. So we're about to get on stage, and a lot of people ask me, am I nervous? Are you scared? And the answer to that is yes. I'm nervous and I'm scared, but with fear, we're gonna do it anyways and hope for the best. The work has been done, so now it's just time to go up there and showcase my hard work. So of course we're scared. Of course we're scared to take a leap, but man, we're gonna do this. We're gonna crush it. Number 61, baby, let's go.
Maybe she didn't feel she could do it so quickly, but as I always say, you look, all we want to do is get first place. And thankfully, we got 3 first place, which the first time ever, that's a win.
Yes, it is.
Win.
Yes.
Naturally.
Now the squad's going to go have a burger. Yay!
Burger time.
There is, of course, I can bring salt. Anything else?
are sweet potato fries with marshmallow fluff.
We are back in the room post burger. Plan now is I have to work on some client programs. I gotta get this tan touched up before finals tonight, but I'm just gonna kick my feet up, work on client check-ins, client programs, and wait till tonight so we can do it all over again. But this time with friends there, with my pops there, with my brother there, so we're gonna have more people cheering in the crowd, so super excited!
Top three tonight, in third place, number 44, Vanessa Guzman. In second tonight, number 61, Nathalie Cardona. And your novice eight champion, number 88, Vesna Morales. All right, ladies, do your favorite front pose. All right, we're ready for awards. Let's do this. Please take fifth place two, number 63, Kimberly Danielle. In fourth tonight, number 77, Ryan Martin. Please take third to number 44, Vanessa Guzman. In second tonight, number 61, Nathalie Corona. And your Bikini A champion, number 67, Alejandra Velasquez. Nice work, ladies. Just put those medals on, make sure they're facing front. And now about your favorite front.
You guys.
Front.
Okay, hold on.
Whatever.
Yeah!
I brought home the motherfucking trophy. I showed up. I showed the fuck up.
So I couldn't sing or celebrate myself on my birthday, obviously because of prep. So my mom made me my NCF kettlebell cake. It is red velvet with cookie dough. So of course we're gonna have this as a post-show dessert slash happy birthday. So happy birthday to me. Congrats to my damn self for coming this far, getting my trophies. I'm scared. How do I get it?
Wherever you want. Doesn't matter. It's your cake.
She's not a regular mom. She's a cool mom.
That's what I was thinking. She's like, woo!
Wow. It is there.
Mom, I'm kind of bad at
girl.
Look at this.
Oh, my God.
Oh. Just cut it. Cut it.